Hello and welcome. This is Randy with Excel for Freelancers, and today I've got a short but very powerful video today where we're going to be creating a PayPal link generator. And basically what this is going to do is allow us to automatically create PayPal links that we can send to our customers and vendors to get paid. Simply by clicking just one button, we'll generate the link. So I'm really excited to show that to you. So please stay tuned. It's going to be an awesome training. All right, let's get started. And today, basically, this PayPal link generator, what we wanted to do is we wanted to be able to enter information and quickly create PayPal links that we can send to customers, vendors, or people who want to pay us. And there's really just three components to create a PayPal link. One would be your PayPal account email. The other would be any type of text that you want, which would be a service or product description, and then the amount that you want to be paid, or the request amount for your PayPal. That's it. Simply enter those three items, then click generate link, and then your link is copied to your computer's clipboard. Once it's been copied, you can then go ahead and paste this into any email or any program or anything, or even a website. So if we were to go here and let's go ahead and delete that, and we paste it in, you'll see that we have a link automatically set up. And then this link basically is pre-formatted and programmed, and that it contains our PayPal email address. It contains the amount that we've requested. And then it also contains our description here, right? And the only difference is in the description, automatically we do replace spaces in the description with %20, which is standard for links. So when we go ahead and click that, and you'll see, let's go ahead and paste this into another browser. And here we go, this one's been pre-formatted. And basically what this does is it'll send the user to a PayPal where they can automatically, let's say we're gonna pay with debit or credit card, automatically when we go to the PayPal, you'll see that we have all of the information here, the amount is here, and our description will be contained as well after the billing information. Automatically. So it's really, really helpful and quick way, as opposed to going into PayPal, signing up on your account, which is what I used to do, and putting all the information in PayPal and then generating a link from there. This is a much, much quicker way to do it. In fact, I use this application each and every time I create PayPal links because it's just so much quicker. And so why don't we go ahead and show you how that's done? All right, I'll walk you through this application, see how we did that. And like I said before, there's just three components to this, and if one component is not, we can put in some conditional formatting here to turn these into yellow. All right, so into conditional formatting, and we manage rules, and I've created rules, but I want to just update those rules. Let's go ahead and delete that one. And basically what we're saying is if the cell is blank, why don't we go ahead and apply to, why don't we click on these three cells here. So what we're saying is if any of these are blank, I want it to turn yellow. Okay, and that's really nice. That way it kind of lets the user know, hey, you know what, we can't leave any cells blank, they're all required, so make sure to do that. Now, how do we go ahead and create that within the VBA? So why don't we go into the VBA so I can show you exactly how we've completed this. Okay, it's actually a very simple macro. From the Developers tab, you can click VBA. You can also click Alt F11. If you don't have the Developers tab available to you, you can locate that from the file menu into options. And then once you see the customized ribbon, you can just make sure your developers is selected here, and that'll get you the developers ribbon. Alt F11 we go, and we only have, let's see, this is another project, so you don't need that. This particular project is the one we're working on, which is the PayPal generator, okay? And there is no sheets here, no macros, just one macro that we're working, which is called the get link macro. And I'll go ahead and explain how we have created this. Let's go ahead and zoom in. All right. And basically, what we need on this is we need to create a link, okay? We need to generate that long text string that I showed you, okay? Now, how do we go ahead and generate that? First, we must dimension a text as a string. So we're going to call it link text, and that's as a string. Okay, and then what we want to do is we want to create a data object, and this data object is going to help us put it to the clipboard. Okay, this is going to help us for the clipboard portion because not only do we have to create the link, but we then need to paste that link into the clipboard so that we can use that in various programs. Okay, since we're only working on sheet one here, which is going to be the applications, and sheet two is nothing, I'll go ahead and delete that later on. So sheet one is all we're going to be working on. So let's go ahead and focus on that. And all we need to do is what we need to do is we need to get the values from H4, H6, and H8. Okay, and once we go over that, we'll see H4 is the email address. H6 is a service or product description, and H8 is the amount that we're going to be paid. Okay, so we need to make sure that first we need to make sure that the user has entered data in each of these. So on this if-then statement, all we're saying is if H4 is empty, or H6 is empty, or right, if H8 is empty, if any of those conditions are met, then I want to do two things. The first of which is I want to send a message, okay, to the user. Message box, please make sure email, service, and amount fields are properly filled out. And step two, I want to exit the sub. That means I don't want to continue on to anything else until that happens. So exit the sub ensures that we do that. And so I'll show you how that works. When the fields are not involved properly, we click the link. We're going to get this message here. Please make sure email, service, and amount fields are properly filled out. Okay, so why don't we go ahead and do that now? Let's just call it donation for great training videos. I'm just saying, not that you have to donate. Well, maybe a little, $5, $10. So now let's go ahead and put in the amount. All right, $20. This is already formatted for a currency field. And then we have a button here, which is it big enough for you? I think that button's big enough, huh? Make it a little bigger. There we go. No, just kidding. Button's big enough. Okay, so that's it. Three components to our link. And let's go ahead and continue on with our macro. And now we want to build this link text, okay? This text field, we need to build it, okay? Now, our PayPal link, based on the PayPal link parameters, needs to begin with a certain specifics, okay? And these are this here. So we've pre-filled out, okay? That is the pre-text. Every link needs to start out with this, okay? And that's regardless of your account, regardless of the service, okay? We can build a link starting with this. And then we have the dynamic fields, okay? Then we have H4. Okay, and H4 is the email address. Okay, so there it says, okay, put in your email address here. Okay, and remember, let's take a look at this. Let me go ahead and paste this link. Here is what the link looks like. Okay, so when it's completed, so the email address is here, the full email address. Then we have the amount, and then the amount is H8 value. H8, okay, remember. So it's just simple 10, and it's not formatted, okay, of anything. It's just the number. So all we're focused on is the number. So make sure that when you build your links, see the format contains the dollar sign, but you'll see the value of the cell is simply 20. So we certainly don't want to enter anything like dollar sign or your currency signal inside the numbers. We don't want that, okay? We just want the amount, and we can put in a decimal if you want to, of course, that's fine, but just make sure there's no dollar signs or pound signs or whatever your currency number is. We simply want only the numbers, okay? The formatting contains the dollar sign, but the value doesn't, okay? So we don't have to worry about that. And so in this case, right, just the number and then the item name, okay? And now links cannot handle spaces, okay? So what we've done, as you'll see here, we have spaces. We have four different spaces. Now, when you create a link, links cannot accept spaces. So there's certain replacements. So there's a certain rules that when you build links, that certain characters and certain spaces are automatically replaced with characters or a combination of characters. And so in this case, spaces are replaced with %20. So we want to make sure that our link doesn't contain any spaces, but we do want to allow the user to create a text or description with spaces. And we can do that simply by replacing spaces. Okay, so what we've done here is we're saying the item name and H6, okay? Right, but before H6, here's the value. Let me just go ahead and highlight that properly. I'll move that over here. Okay, so here it is, H6. Okay, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to embed this value in a replace statement. So that means that they're going to take this value of H6, and put it in the replace statement. Here's the replace, right? And it's going to say, what should I replace? What are we looking for, which is spaces here, and what are we going to replace that space with? We're going to replace it with %20, okay? So this entire little statement takes care of that. So it automatically basically replaces any spaces found with %20. So that's how you get, when you have training video donation, you automatically get the %20, and that's important for a link. Okay, so that's how we build a link. And the next thing we want to do is we want to take that link, we want to put it in a cell in our workbook, and then we want to take that and we want to create a data object for that and put that into the clipboard. So these three lines of code do that, okay? We put it in A100, and then we set the data object to a new data object. It's not so important that you know exactly how this works, except all you need to know is that these three lines of code enable us to put it to the clipboard, right? Because we could paste the text here in Excel and then right click, copy, but you don't want to do that. We just want to generate it and boom, we want to paste it. And then when we paste it, it's right here. You see, it's one step. It's really fast, right? And that's what I want, because I want to paste it in any other application. Right. Often I use this whether it's a messenger chat or whether it's email or any other application. I want to paste it quickly. I want it fast. And so this allows us to do that. So those last three lines of code allows us to put it to the clipboard. Put in clipboard. Right. Text object put in clipboard. OK, so that's really helpful. And then all we have is the confirmation message, right? Your custom PayPal link has been copied to the clipboard. That's it. It's a super, super, super simple macro. And it's probably one of the easiest trainings, but it's also one of the most powerful for freelancers. This is one of the most important, because we often create PayPal links very often to send to our customers so that we can get paid quickly. And this program allows us to do that, to get paid extremely quickly using the PayPal link generator. So I wanted to make sure to show that to you today and also give you a copy free for download, because I'm kind like that and nice and friendly. But all I ask, of course, is that you do share it with your friends, share it on Facebook. And there's some new Facebook rules that doesn't allow us to share so much from a business page. So I'm really counting on you guys to share this with everybody you know, and they'll really appreciate it, especially freelancers. So if you feel that this could be of use to them, please share this with your friends, let them know the video, and go ahead and give us a shout out, and we'd really appreciate that. Thanks so much for joining us, and have a great day.